Dawson Ryder with you.
Hey YouTube, Dawson Ryder here. This is going to be my review for the last ever issue of the Go-Go Power Rangers comic. I am going to primarily be reviewing, obviously, the last issue, but I will be mentioning sort of stuff from the last couple issues that kind of set up this last arc. I will be doing, down the road here shortly, a overall series review where I'll go more in depth on the whole series and specifically the last arc that I haven't covered since my last Go-Go Power Rangers catch-up, but since this is the last issue, I specifically wanted to do a review on it. So this last arc has basically been about the power transfer, as Jason, Zack, and Trini have been recruited by one of the emissaries to help out fighting these like morphing grid mutants, basically. And basically their time is stretched. You know, they're helping out with this alien stuff, so they don't have time to do MMPR stuff. Like, it's as opposed to the show where they were scubaing and being stock actors, because if you didn't know, real quick recap, in real life in the show, and these are also separate timelines, the show universe is separate from the Boom timeline, but in the show, three of the actors left unceremoniously, so they had to come up with loopholes for the recasts and the power transfer. It's one of those things where you're simultaneously impressed they pulled it off, but also you can't believe that you didn't notice when you were little. But so in this timeline though, they have a legit reason, which is the Omega Ranger stuff. But basically this arc has been about, they just realize they can't pull double duty and they have to leave. They come up with a lie about Switzerland, because as of this moment, Zordon thinks they're going to Switzerland. Of course he later finds out in the main comic that's not true. But so they need to the power transfer. And this has been about the power transfer, the official origins of the Omega Rangers, how they got their powers, and the consequences of that. I think that's the main thing that's made the comics in general interesting, and the Go-Go Power Rangers stuff, is it really fleshes out a lot of the mythology and the character stuff like the show didn't. Like, it deals with the actual consequences and backlash of them making this decision. In the show, it was all Stepford stuff, like, oh, we're best friends. You're gonna go to charity. I can't wait for you to do charity, and charity, and charity, we're goody two-shoes. Let's go paint someone's house. But in this one, the Rangers are legit kind of upset. Like, why are you leaving right now? Like, Zed just arrived, he's a super great threat, not Ultra. He just blew up this planet we were on with this new Zord, and you're about to leave to go talk about peace? And Tommy talks to Jason, he's like, look, don't leave. What the heck are you doing, man? Like, it wasn't too long ago you guys were desperate for me to stay on as the Green Ranger, and I fought hard to come back and become the White Ranger to join you guys, and now you're gonna just leave like that? And obviously he doesn't realize the real reasons as of this moment, but I really like those honest consequences to it. It's interesting seeing the conflict of the Rangers that are leaving, the Rangers that are staying behind, how the transition for the new teammates isn't going so well. We get a little bit about Rocky, Adam, and Aisha in this one, talking about being excited of being Rangers. That is one of my nitpicks about this last arc, and honestly, this overall Necessary Evil arc, is I feel like Rocky, Adam, and Aisha haven't gotten a lot of attention. I know that the Omega Rangers seem to be the focus, but I think they do such a good job of fleshing out other stuff from the show. I wish they would have fleshed out the new trio's relationship with everyone, because even though it was all Stepford-y, like, in the show, you got the vibe that they were friends. Like, it made sense, like, these are three new friends, they know their secret identity, they've helped out before, they're a natural choice. But in the comic, it feels like they're just random strangers they met once on Facebook. And I wish that they would have included that a little bit, because some of the previous issues do include stuff about how the Rangers are struggling when Jason, Zack, and Trini are missing. And it would have been cool to see the three new Rangers hanging out with them, maybe offering some help as civilians somehow. I think that could have played into it. You still could have very easily had, like, the non-easy transition of them being Rangers and not being up to it quite yet, but I think that it would have made it a better sell. It just seems awkward in this one. It was nice to get a little bit of their POV, but I think that's been one of the drawbacks, and I hope they get more attention in the future, assuming we're continuing with this line of characters. Really cool to see all those consequences, and then also very cool at the end of the issue, we get to see the origins of how they got their Omega Ranger powers. A cool tidbit right before they do, Trini and all of them mention that they feel this hollowness, and they feel like empty, and they feel like the lack of the Morphing Grid connection, which is a really cool bit. It kind of reminded me of Dino Thunder when they mentioned like how they felt different when the Dino Gems were destroyed, since now they were cut off from the Morphing Grid. I always appreciate to hear little details like that. But they get their Omega powers, we get a little bit of explanation on them. honestly nothing too new, but it was kind of neat. The emissary explains that they're some of the most ancient ranger powers of a ranger force that was known for patrolling the darkest corners of the galaxy to protect it, and that their Zords are based off of the ancient aliens at the time. Like, it was cool to hear it in there, but it's not really any new information that we haven't heard from one of the writers that's talked about in an interview, just saying, like, they're ancient. But it was cool to get a little bit. I really hope we get more full Omega Ranger origins later. That would be really cool. But it was neat still to see a little explanation on them, and you get their sort of power getting sequence. That's some good talking, Dawson. It's kind of an homage to Day of the Dumpster when, you know, Zordon's like, oh, you're super courageous and you like bubblegum. You're the new Yellow Ranger. Or, you know, I really like your glasses. You're the new Blue Ranger. Except he said more epic stuff than that. And he says stuff like that, like, Jason, you know, resourceful and brave. You're the new Omega Ranger. So they do a sequence like that. It's kind of an homage to Day of the Dumpster, which was really cool. And then, like, the last bit of the issue, you see the new MMPR team going out simultaneously when the Omega team's going out, which was really cool. Like, overall, it was a really great last issue. Last issue to this arc. I really did enjoy reading it. I love all the in-depth character stuff, the in-depth lore stuff. I love that in this universe there's an actual interesting reason why the three left that just enhances it so much. I've enjoyed that storyline overall. Like, just specifically as the last issue, I would give this a 9. It was a great issue for what it was. My only nitpick really comes from this whole arc, which I'll get into more in the series review, is I feel that the MMPR and GoGo comics, as we've gone on, have not felt very different from each other. It feels like we're just reading the same comic, and the backstory part of me just wishes was made into flashback stories in the MMPR comic, but I'll get into that in the series review. It just hasn't felt that different since GoGo essentially turned into a pickup of where MMPR left off before Shattered Grid, and then MMPR just jumped ahead, so it's been the same. But again, just to repeat myself, that I'll have some overall thoughts about that. Setting my nitpicks about the format aside, these were some really good last issues, a strong last issue, I think kind of a cool place to leave off the series. I'm kind of curious if there's anybody that only reads GoGo, because this would honestly be really cool and surprising for them if they didn't somehow know about the main comic and the Omega Ranger stuff. If there's anybody that does just read GoGo, let me know in the comments, I'm curious. But what did you think? Did you enjoy the final issue or issues of GoGo Power Rangers? Do you enjoy the series overall? I know it was kind of a pleasant surprise for me. Are you sorry to see it go? Let me know in the comments as always. I will be doing a series review very soon. There's lots of PR related stuff going on in other reviews right now, so it might get pushed a little bit, and I kind of want to revisit some of the earlier issues, but I will be putting together sometime soonish a series review of the whole series overall. Anyway, until next time, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and climb the steps and ring that bell for notifications for my videos. Dawson Ryder, signing out.